Time is priceless, and with each moment, it's ticking away. Therefore, it's important that we value it and mention it properly. When an action or event takes place, at what time of the day it takes place, or at what day of the week, month, year it takes place, or for how long it takes place, and all other related questions are answered by prepositions of time. Therefore, in this lesson, we will learn to use prepositions of time at, in, and on that we use quite frequently in our daily communication. In this lesson, we'll learn to use them correctly to mention period, day, week, month, and year when an action or event takes place. Friends, my name is Hemant Singh Rana, and you're watching Enliven English, making the language entertaining, lively, and functional. So let's get started. Let's start our discussion with preposition at. At as preposition of time means definite or particular point of time of the day. When we say a definite point of time of the day, it means exact time on the clock, such as at 7 a.m., at 5 p.m., at 10 o'clock, and so on. And when we say particular point of time of the day, it means at noon, at midday, and at midnight. Let's have a look at some examples. The meeting will begin at 10 a.m. and end at 2 o'clock. The concert is expected to end at midnight. We will go for a walk at 5:30 in the morning. He is rarely available in the office at noon. The sentences we just saw were the examples of exact or particular point of time when something happens or will happen. We can also use preposition at with indefinite periods of time, such as at dusk, at dawn, at night, at sunrise, at sunset, etc. Let's have a look at some examples. The view from here is spectacular at sunrise. They like to go for a walk on the beach at sunset. Birds leave their nests at dawn. The road wears a deserted look at night. Other indefinite periods of time that we can mention with preposition at are meal times, such as at breakfast, at lunch, at dinner, and short holiday periods of 2 or 3 days, such as at Christmas, at weekend, at New Year, and so on. Let's have a look at some examples. All employees will assemble in the hall at lunchtime. I invited my old friends at dinner last night. My friends have decided to meet me at Christmas. At New Year, we will go on a long vacation. Some common expressions with preposition at that we come across daily are at the weekend or at weekends, at the moment, at present, at the same time, etc. Let's have a look at some examples. We will try to catch up at the weekend. They go on a long drive at weekends. None is present in the room at the moment. You have to complete the 2 assignments at the same time. Now let's talk about preposition in. We use in with parts of the day, like in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, and so on. We also use in with longer periods of time, like days, weeks, months, years, decades, centuries, seasons, and so on. Let's have a look at some sentences to understand this better. Mark visits the gym in the morning. We will meet at a nearby hotel in the afternoon. We regularly go for a walk on the beach in the evening. In all the 3 sentences, we are talking about a part of the day. We are planning to go on vacation in June. In 2018, the economy grew at a rapid pace. We will achieve our targets in 2019 only. In the last three sentences, we are talking about particular months and years. The team believes it will improve its performance in the future. In the past, they used to take their opponents lightly. The life was comparatively easier in the 1990s. Great poets like William Wordsworth and John Keats flourished in the 19th century. The just mentioned sentences are talking about longer periods of time, decades and centuries. We visit London in summer and India in winter. Flowers of myriad hues are visible in spring. In the last two sentences, we are talking about seasons. With preposition in plus length of time, we can answer how long it takes something to finish and what happens in a particular length of time. For example, they covered 4 miles in 1 hour. We'll finish the project in a few days. We'll return in 6 months. The breakfast will be ready in 8 minutes. All these sentences are answering how long it takes to do something. Now preposition on. We use preposition on to talk about an exact day and date or a particular part of the day. Also, we use on with a singular day of the week to refer to an occasion and plural day of the week to refer to repeated events or occasions. Let's see some sentences. There's an important meeting on June 15th. We are planning a lavish party on Sunday. We are leaving for the US on Sunday morning. The office remains closed on Sundays. We hold our meetings on Mondays. In the last two sentences, plural day of the week is used to refer to events which repeat themselves on those particular days. With special days such as birthdays and anniversaries and other important days like Valentine's Day, International Women's Day and so on, we use preposition of time on. For example, I have invited all my friends on my mom's birthday. They wanted to spend some time alone on their marriage anniversary. Love is in the air on Valentine's Day. So friends, that is it in this lesson. I hope from now on you will be able to use prepositions of time in, at and on more confidently. If you have any doubts, do get in touch with me. Now we know where to use prepositions in, at and on. The next lesson will be about gaining more clarity and removing doubts with regard to these three prepositions. I'll be back with you soon with a new lesson. Till then, keep learning and keep improving. Goodbye.